Nice to see you.
The ambassador, Mr. President?
President.
How are you, sir? This is again.
Nice to see you.
Mr. Cox.
Delighted.
Come in.
How are you? Nice to see you, sir. Glad to see you. I know. Nice to see you, sir. How are you, Mr. Minister? Good to see you, sir.
President.
You guys are president.
Nice to see you.
I know our time is limited here, but I want you to know that we admire your courage and the fight that you've been putting up. Hope you will stay with us. We intend to do everything we can to cooperate, bringing about a solution and leading your country now to its dictators and democracy to Panama.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President-elect, I want to express my appreciation for having this opportunity to discuss with you the situation in Panama.
Good to see you.
Thank you.
Well, I have every confidence in you and taking over now in the negotiations there for the access agreement and the access agreement with Oman. They're very important to us.
Well, thank you, Mr. President. Our relations with them have improved greatly during the administration, and I hope I can keep them up as
well. Well, I'm sure you will. Maybe just a little something so you won't forget us.
Thank you.
All right.
Merry Christmas to you, Mr. President.
Well, Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you.
Ambassador Brown.
Yes. Good morning, Mr. President.
Hello there.
Delighted to meet you, sir.
Nice to see you. Now,
may I introduce my wife, Bill?
Here's my brother, Matt.
Hello there.
I'm so glad to be with
nice
you again,
you.
Really.
And this is my mother, Mrs. McConnell.
Nice.
Hello. Come over now.
See you.
These are my daughters, Mr. President.
Hello.
Joanna Maria. Yeah. And Dr. Margarita, she's a veterinarian.
Well,
Anastasia, she's an actress,
well,
by the way.
Well,
and one absent, our son is a B-52
pilot.
I
understand.
And he couldn't make it.
But I think we ought to have a family.
All right.
We just want to be over there.
Mom?
Hi,
how are you?
Thank you. Well, you're taking over at rather a strange time here. We have to have some room on that so that you...
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you very much.
Israel loves you, Mr. President, and they sure hope that your policies will be sustained, and we're confident that they will be.
I can assure you of that, and I know George and how he feels. They must realize that they may do it their way. We have no intention of reducing our support obligation to Israel.
And yourself, Mr. President.
It's a key record with the seal.
Oh, thank you, sir.
One of you wants to give it to your son, he's absent.
He's a B-52 pilot, and he will treasure this.
Oh, well, I wish you well, and I have every confidence that you will.
And to you and the First Lady, the very, very best wishes of all the nation. And of Israel as well, sir.
Well, thank
we thank you very, very much, sir. Appreciate this.
Ambassador Spearman.
Yes,
you, sir.
Ambassador.
Thank you so much.
Good to see you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, good
nice
to see you.
Have an opportunity to say hello to you.
Please meet
my wife.
I'm sorry.
My wife.
Good to see you.
Good. Hi, Lynn. How are you? Okay, thank you. Good.
And my youngest son, Charles.
Hello there. Now I think we ought to get a family grouping.
Okay.
And move up here. Well, why don't you come here and then you come there and...
Okay.
Maybe somebody over here.
Oh, we all here? Okay.
That's fine, right?
That's fine.
Great.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Well, it's good to see you. Don't wait here. I know that one day you've got to have some mental suit.
That's right.
I promise.
Thank you.
Then we thought maybe some keywords.
Thank you very much.
Sam Seal.
Standing in the rear here.
Have a happy holiday.
I know it's got some problems in Rwanda. It's been so good about taking in those refugees from Burundi. But I understand now that many of them are returning.
Well, we're hoping that when I left, there were just about 3,000. And out of 43,000 people, most of those are intellectuals. Maybe some were apprehensive at this point until they discovered. But the situation, President Habyarimana did a tremendous job in maintaining a stable region and played a great role in keeping the peace in the area. We like to have an ambassador there that was helping.
Well, we
like to believe we played a small part in it, but thanks to your support and the administration's support.
Thanks to you.
Well, thank you, and we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to you and Mrs. Hill.
Yeah.
We sent you a little caricature of a soccer game that we played against the Soviets and with you and Mr. Gorbachev on one side. I don't know whether you ever had a chance to see it, but it was a little soccer contest, and one of the people on our staff put it together, and they beat us 15-3, 15-1, and 15-6. Well, maybe that's why they didn't. Well, we're going to play them American softball when we get back.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Mr. President, Ambassador
yes.
Tara.
Dan, we're a little bit late with this, aren't we?
Oh, so good to see you.
Take a
sure, it's nice to see you. And this is Judith, of course, you
How
know.
How are you, Mr. President? Such a pleasure. Yeah.
Why don't you get right in the middle of our family?
Thank you.
Very good.
Well,
very good. We took a good vacation, yes it does.
I was sort of reminiscing
one day. After you get some rest, why we'll sit down and talk about some of those right reminiscences.
All right. Just a couple of souvenirs and mementos.
Oh, well, you're very kind.
Each of you. Well, good to see you, and thank you for all that you've been doing.
Aside from everything, I did the 200 speeches. Never wavered once with your policies.
Isn't that wonderful?
Never wavered once.
Well, bless you. I know you wouldn't.
Yeah.
It's been a great 8 years.
And congratulations on a job well done for you.
Well, thank you.
Yeah.
Very much.
Thanks. Well,
nice to see you.
Thank you. And a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
President Congressman Coates.
Yes, hi.
President.
How are you?
How are you?
It's fine.
We're certainly going to miss you.
Probably more than they're going to miss me than you. But congratulations.
You know, it would have been empowering to serve in the House these last 8 years, not you in the Senate, without you being in the Oval Office, your agenda. So we thank you for all you've done for the country. My wife, Martha.
Nice to
see you. And my son, Andrew.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
And daughter, Lisa.
Hi.
And daughter, Laura.
Hello there.
Laura's a junior in college, Grace is in high school, and Andrew's in fifth grade.
Well, I think maybe we ought to get a family photo here. We're in the middle of maybe flanked by the children. Can I have maybe one of you over here?
Okay.
And you should be in here.
All right.
You've done this before.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, my longtime friend, Bob Warner, did it again.
Well, thank you. He was, it was a long process, but good.
Thank you.
Thankful that we have the opportunity to do it. Excited about it. And we wish you the very, very best.
Okay.
You and Nancy. See you again, but we understand that you don't ever want to.
Well, as long as it appears in your state that you've got to run again now.
Run again in 1990, run again in 1992. So our work's kind of ours. But we're feeling we're up to it. We're going to do it as a family. We're going to have a good time. Do it as a good time.
How are the fundraisers?
We'd love to have you come.
We will take you up on that offer.
Mr. President, excuse me, let me introduce Dave Hoppe, Dan's top staff.
Oh,
well, he's going to be responsible for getting me back here in 1990.
I hope so. I'm going to work at it.
Good.
Nice to meet you.
What are you looking forward to most of all here as you go to California to get some rest?
Well,
what's happening.
Look at this. President,
look at that.
Good
girl.
To see you. You haven't seen these girls in 4 years.
I haven't seen you when I last saw you were this big. How are you?
Jennifer, Tiffany.
Nice to see you. Hi, how are you? Good to see you.
Well, now, on a group picture they say in front of the desk,
okay.
What is your desire? All of us in the picture together or two separate
could
pictures?
Could we do two separate? Would that be okay?
All right, well, I'll be the one you have to smile to, right?
You take the lead.
Yes, maybe you want to be in the middle. Okay. Let's put that over here. The girls.
Right.
Kind of be in front.
Jennifer, you can come in front of me here.
You're about the president here.
Yeah, that's right.
All right, girls, ready?
Okay.
Your sister, your baby sister, didn't smile.
Well, all right.
At least she's quiet. That's the main thing.
Okay, here we are.
Here we are.
Okay.
You want to do one of
that? Yeah, that'd be great.
There we go.
That's one, right? Do everything I can.
Yeah. Thank you.
The baby one. I have found out that babies get fascinated by that.
Yes.
And they just, that's all they look at.
Tiffany, you want to get their...
Well, her main concern is that thumb. There's lots of thumbs in her mouth, and she's...
So cute.
She's August, or
August. August. Yeah.
Yeah. What grade are you in? Second grader?
That's for all your grandchildren here. For
girls.
Is this for me?
Oh, look.
That's what the president's got a present for you.
Oh,
thank you.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you.
That's very
nice. Well, thank you. Now, we just thought that maybe you might have need for a book bag.
You said
you say.
And you'll be coming up to need one of those. And then that one's far away from what you needed,
but
maybe one of you could take and take that for your little sister or when she's ready.
That's great, thank you.
And these are all for Mama and Papa, since Papa's got his arms full.
Thank you very much.
All right.
That's terrific.
I've got a Russian story for both of you before we leave.
Russian story?
Russian story. An American entrepreneur went to Moscow and had a very successful week of doing business. He finished his business on Friday, and his airplane wasn't delayed till Monday. So his Russian host said, is there anything you'd like to do over the weekend? And he said, well, yes. He said, I'd really like to buy a sable for my wife. And he said, oh, yes, every visitor to Russia would like to do that, but it's a year waiting list, so that's not possible. He said, is there a second wish? And he said, well, if I could see the Bolshoi, I'd love to do that. And he said, oh, yes, everyone wants to do that. Every Russian wants to see it. That's a 2-year waiting list.
how about a third thing? And he says, well, I'd like to see Lenin's tomb. And he said, well, that you can do, but you'd have to get up before dawn and stand in line for 8 hours, and then just maybe you'd get to see him. So the American says, you just leave me alone, and you pick me up on Monday, and I'll just be on my own for the weekend. On Monday morning, the limousine pulls up, and the Russian sees the American come out of the hotel with a huge bundle under his arm. And he says to the American, what's that? And he says, it's the sable for my wife. He said, well, how did you get that? And he said, well, it's very simple. I went to the shop and met the owner of the shop and said, I'd like to buy 2 sable coats, but I only have need for one. What you do with the other is your business. So he said, I got my sable. And he said, well, did you go to the ballet? And he said, well, matter of fact, I did. He said, I stood in line and asked to see the manager and said I wanted to buy 12 tickets, but I had need for only one. And what he did with the other 11 were his business. And he said, and I suppose you saw Lenin too? And he said, well, I did, but I didn't get up too early. I got there about noon, and the line went on forever. So I went to the front of the line and asked to see the captain of the guard and said, I've got $100 here if I can see Lenin. And the captain said, do you want to go in to see him, or do you want me to bring him to you? Well, listen, thank you very much. And congratulations to you, sir.
I can't resist giving the Russian story about the Moscow summit that we heard at the Moscow summit. And this is their story. This is one they tell about themselves. I've been collecting those. Well, this is one that I am in the limousine with Gorbachev, head of my secret service, and me, and Gorbachev has his security man, and we're sightseeing, and we come to a waterfall, and we all get out, and we're looking at this beautiful waterfall, and Gorbachev says to my secret service man, go ahead, jump, go over the fall. My man said, I got a wife and 3 kids. So he turned to his own man and said, you, go, jump, go over the fall, and he did. And my man scrambled down around the rocks to see if he could be of help down at the bottom, found him, ran his clothes out down there. And he said, when he told you to jump and go over the falls, why did you do that? He said, I got a wife and 3 kids.
Thank you very much.
Well, Merry Christmas to all of us.
Yes, Merry Christmas.
Good to see you today, sir. Good luck.
Good luck. Merry
Christmas. Good to see you all.
Thanks for my present.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Say hello to Mr. Forrest.
Yes. Three more of those in the time.
No, that's it. No more.
Thank you very much.
Okay.